Good morning, students. Welcome to Narayana Live Classes. I, Anjaneya, going to discuss the key of assignment dated on 8-7-2020 on the topic triangles. And in the first question, they had given us, in the given figure, they had given OA is equal to OB, OD is equal to OC, and I have to prove AOD triangle is congruent to BOC triangle. AOD and BOC, we have to prove these two triangles are congruent. And also we have to prove AD is parallel to BC. AD is parallel to BC. So I'll start with the solution. I say in triangle we know in triangle AOD and triangle BOC, in these two triangles we know that OA is equal to OB. This is given to us. Then OD is equal to OC. This is also given to us. And we know these two angles, angle AOD and BOC, forms vertically opposite angles. Angle AOD and angle BOC forms vertically opposite angles. And we know vertically opposite angles are equal. So I can say angle AOD is equal to angle BOC. Therefore, I say, see now, side, angle, side. Therefore, these two triangles, triangle AOD is congruent to triangle BOC by SAS congruence rule. Congruence rule. Now, we know two triangles are congruent. Therefore, corresponding angles, we can say, corresponding parts of congruent triangles are equal. So I can say angle AOAD is equal to angle OBC. That is, angle OAD is equal to angle OBC, and the reason for this is CPCT. That is, corresponding parts of congruent triangles. Now, but if you see these two angles, they form, if I consider this AB as a transversal, these two angles are nothing but forms alternate angles. So I'll say angle OAD and angle OBC are alternate interior angles. For which two lines? For AD and BC. For lines AD and BC. Therefore, I can say that AD is parallel to BC. Now, coming to the second question, they had given AB is the line segment. AB is the line segment. And line L is drawn perpendicular bisector of AB. Perpendicular bisector. There it is perpendicular also and it is bisecting also. If it is bisecting, I can directly say AC is equal to BC. Now what I have to prove? I have to prove if a point lies on L, show that P is equidistant from A and B. This I have to prove. P PA is equal to PB, I have to prove it. PA is equal to PB. So I start with the solution, and solution said, first I will say line L is perpendicular to AB and also passes through point C, which is a midpoint of AB. And we have to prove PA is equal to PB. So I say, consider triangle PCA and triangle PCB. In that, we know that AC is equal to AC is equal to CB or BC, you say. You will say C is midpoint. C is midpoint of AB. C is the midpoint of AB, so both are equal. I say angle PCA, that is PCA, angle PCA is equal to PCB. PCB will say each is 90. Each is 90 degree. And also PC is congruent to PC. Common side will say PC is equal to PC. Will say common side. Therefore, we can say triangle PCA is congruent to triangle PCB by SAS test of congruence. SAS congruence rule. Now we know if two triangles are congruent, corresponding parts are equal of congruent triangles. If two triangles are congruent, their corresponding parts are equal. So I can say side PA is equal to PB. So I can say PA is equal to PB. I will say corresponding sides of congruent triangles. And that is my required proof. Coming to the third question, they had given line segment AB and line segment CD. These two are parallel. And O is midpoint of AD. O is midpoint of AD means OA will be equal to OD. I have to prove angle AOB is congruent to DOC. These two triangles are congruent. And O is the midpoint of BC. O is the midpoint of BC. So I start with the proof. Consider triangle AOB and DOC. These two triangles I consider. In that, I know AB line segment and CD line segment are parallel to each other. And CD has a transversal. I can say angle ABO, this angle, and DCO, this angle, are alternate angles. Correct. I say angle ABO is equal to angle DCO. I'll say alternate angles. As AB and DC are parallel, and we know BC has transversal. Also we know that OB, OA is equal to OD. OA is equal to OD, and this is vertically opposite angle. That is angle, I'll say angle AOB is equal to angle DOC, I'll say vertically opposite angle. And we know OA is equal 4 is midpoint of AD. So what we get? We get this side, this is vertically opposite angle. So angle, 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 side. So these two triangles, that is triangle AOB, is congruent to triangle DOC by AAS congruence of triangle rule. So that is my first part of the proof. Now for the second part, it is very simple. If two triangles are congruent, their corresponding parts are congruent or equally say. So I can directly say OB is equal to OC. I'll say corresponding parts of congruent triangles, corresponding side of congruent triangle. And that is my second required proof, that is OB is equal to OC, therefore I can say that O is the midpoint of BC.